When you're updating your Creative Cloud apps, there are two types of updates you need to know about. First, there's the dot release. This is when the number after the dot changes. Then there's the major release, which is when the number before the dot changes. Now let's talk about customizations. If you've set up preferences, keyboard shortcuts, or workspace layouts, you might want to bring those along with you when updating. You can manage it through the Creative Cloud desktop app by selecting Manage Auto Updates or clicking on your profile photo, then going to Preferences. Apps. Advanced Options. Check Import Previous Settings and Preferences so everything transfers over when the auto update happens. If you don't have auto update enabled, no problem. The app will still ask you about migrating your preferences when you update. Before you hit that update button though, don't forget to check for updates to your graphics drivers. There are links in the description to learn how to do that. It's also a good idea to clear your cache between updates. To do this, just launch Premiere while holding down Command on Mac or Control on Windows. This will give you the option to clear media cache files. Select that and hit Continue. If you're updating to a major version of Premiere, you'll want to do a bit more maintenance. Make sure to check for updates on any third-party plugins you use. You can manage these in the Apps tab of the Creative Cloud desktop app. Just click the More menu on your app to see the plugins, and if you didn't get a plugin from Creative Cloud, you'll need to head over to the Plugin Creators website to download the latest version. Follow these steps, and your Premiere Pro update should go off without a hitch. If you've got any questions, don't hesitate to reach out. Make sure to subscribe for more Adobe tips.